immediately we get that thing we have been wishing for, we start looking for the next thing we want to get in life. When I hit 13k subscribers, I talked about like I can't wait to get to 20k, that will come on here, you know, do a lot of stuff. I can't wait to get to 2 million. Like, I was looking forward to getting to 20k subscribers and 2 million views on YouTube. Yeah, and guess what, you guys, I hit those threshold last year December. I can't remember the date, but it was pretty much earlier than I thought I would. So I hit those milestones, and trust me, I was grateful, I was happy. I posted on my community tab that I hit 20k subscribers on YouTube, you know, blah blah blah. I even did giveaway there. I don't know why I jumped right into this topic without any proper without welcoming you all to the channel. I'm sorry. I am so eager to letting this whole thought in my mind, of letting this whole topic out, so I don't get interrupted, so I don't forget any of the point that I want to lay out. So hey you all, how are you all doing? It's me, Catherine, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome if this is your first time or seeing this pretty face. Hope you are good, hope you are fine, and yeah, I think that is pretty much it. So you guys, like I was saying, when I hit 20k subscribers and 2 million views on YouTube, those threshold I have looked forward to for a very long time. Like, I was like, oh my god, how am I gonna behave when I hit this threshold? I was like, I think I surprised a lot about how I would react, about how I would feel, you know, all that kind of thing. But when it finally happened, I never felt those things that I thought I would feel. Like, I never behaved like I thought I would behave. I never saw myself like I thought I would see myself. And it got me questioning what's going on. I thought that I was gonna come on here to talk about, you know, to come appreciate you all, talk about my journey, you know, give a little more, like one or two insights, you know, stuff like that, but I never did. Guess the reason why I actually never did. I didn't want to hear congratulations again. Who does that? Like, who runs away from congratulations? Over the last couple of months, I have been getting tons of congratulations. Like, every now and then, when I hit a threshold, I show my community, or I even make a video about it, I was constantly getting congratulations. When I go on Instagram, I hit a threshold, even on TikTok, I was constantly getting congratulations, to the point that when I got, like, the recent one, I got myself a camera, I got tons of congratulations. It was becoming overwhelming. I didn't know how to feel anymore. It became overwhelming for me, you know, and that was the reason why I felt like me coming on here to be appreciative of my 20k subscribers and my 2 million views, it will invite more congratulations, which I felt like I wasn't ready for anymore. And it got me thinking, why was I feeling that way? And to think that even after hitting those thresholds, I started looking forward to the next, like 30k to come, 3 million views to come, you know. I started looking out to the next threshold I will hit on YouTube, and I'm now looking forward to getting more. I am looking forward to achieving more. I remember when I was around 1k subscribers, 2k subscribers, I see YouTubers with around 10k subscribers, even 7k subscribers and above, and I'm always like, oh my god, I can't wait to get to this stage. Like, I see them, and I see them as big YouTubers, 10k subscribers, 20k subscribers, oh my god, like, I respect them so much. I feel like they are these big YouTubers that have done well for themselves. I remember looking forward to when I would start earning monthly on YouTube. I dread for it, like, I dread for these things, and I am there now. But I don't know, I don't feel the things I thought that I would feel. The reason I'm here to talk about this is, we fail to enjoy the stages that we are in life. We are always wanting more. We are always looking forward to the next places that we want. Like, we're always looking forward to the next thing that we want to get, that we don't enjoy the stages we are in life. We started this new year with a lot of us writing our new year resolutions, our goals for the year, the things we want to achieve for the year, and some of us will feel like, oh my God, we didn't achieve the things we wanted to achieve in the previous year, being 2022. Yeah, I know a lot of people will feel like that, and we'll go into the new year wanting to like, oh my God, I'm gonna get this. For me, on the other way around, I felt like I had a lot, I accomplished a lot in the year 2022. I had a lot to be grateful for, but that didn't stop me from going, from coming into, that didn't stop me from entering into this year without expectations. Like, I have my resolutions, I have my goals, I have milestones that I want to achieve, you know, that kind of stuff. And that is not a bad thing, actually. That is not a bad thing. But I am now learning to pause and enjoy the each stages that I find myself, to take a deep breath in between my hard work, to enjoy my achievements, you know, to catch a breath, to watch the movies I want to watch, to spend time with my family. There's nothing wrong with wanting more, but then again, how did you feel when what you prayed for happened? I'm not saying you weren't happy, you might be happy, but did you feel as excited as you thought you would feel when that thing you have been praying for, when that thing you have been wishing for, when it happened, did you feel as excited as you thought you would feel? What I've come to realize is that no matter the stage you get in life, when you don't learn the habit of contentment, when you don't learn the habit of savoring the stage, any stage you find yourself, when you don't learn the habit of enjoying and reflecting on any stage you find yourself, no matter the peak, no matter, even though you get to the highest peak, you would always want more. You would always keep on wanting more. That's it. That's the truth. You will always, always keep on wanting more. We all just have to learn to slow down, to enjoy any stage we find ourselves. Even though that I want to get more, but it should be a slow, but I shouldn't like make it be my entire being. I shouldn't make it look like, oh my God, this is what I was like, this is the only thing I'm focused on. I want to enjoy the process, every stage that I've found myself through life, like through my whole life, through my whole career, my content creation, my all my platform. I want to savor it and reflect on them. I want to enjoy as I create. I don't want it to be in a hush-hush way that, oh my God, this is the time I'm supposed to post today. So because I am almost beating the time, I will start. Like, there was this vlog that I posted recently. It was supposed to be, okay, my previous vlog, that was my first vlog of the year. It's still my first vlog of the year because I haven't posted since that vlog. And I almost made a huge mistake. I posted that vlog without an intro, without nothing. It just started like that. And after like 20 minutes of it being published, I was watching it and I'm like, no, I hate this. I remember rushing to upload that video. I remember rushing to edit it. Everything, I was just rushing it. And I uploaded it. I was like, oh my God, thank God, I am done editing this. Let me just upload it, because I was supposed to upload video on that day. But when I was watching it, I said, this is not me. There's no creativity in this at all. There's no creativity. There's no life in this video at all. And I took it down at once. It was after 20 minutes that I realized this. I took it down. And I had to re-edit. I had to take my time. Overnight, I re-edited it. I took my time. I put my creativity into it. And I loved it. That is the type of content I want to be putting out. The content that I love, you know. And not because I am against time. I want to enjoy every stage that I hit, whether it's fast or not, whether it's slow, whether it's fast, whether whatever situation that I find myself in life, I want to start enjoying it. And I'm encouraging every one of you to enjoy every stage you find yourself. Enjoy it. Let us stop looking to the next thing, to the next thing that we want to achieve. Let us stop looking to the next thing that we forget to feel what we want to feel when we got what we wanted to get. I don't know if I'm making sense. A lot of the times, we forget to feel what we want to feel. When we get what we have been wishing for, what we have been praying for, what we want to get, all because immediately we get that thing we have been wishing for, we start looking for the next thing we want to get in life. I don't know if you guys are feeling me. Like, this happens a lot. We start pursuing the next available thing. We start chasing the next thing without reflecting on the thing we just got. You know, without putting in all the gratitude we thought we were going to put in, like we're going to give to God, without enjoying what we just got. I am encouraging all of us to begin this habit of savoring every stage we find ourselves in life, of enjoying every time stage. Don't think about it so much. Don't pressure yourself like, oh, you're not growing. In case you're a YouTuber, you start feeling like, oh, your growth is slow, you're not growing. Please enjoy that stage. Because have you ever thought why you see like YouTubers who just come into the system, who just come into the platform, and immediately like they blow up, like their first video, second video, they are doing well, third video they are doing well, and all of a sudden they don't post anymore? It's because they had it in a very easy way and the zeal isn't there, you know. I don't know how to put it, but you guys understand what I mean. Like, I see this a lot for YouTubers who had easy, who have easy access on this platform. They don't last long. Or you see those people who branded, who it took years for them to get to where they want, who it took years to grow their platform. They are still there and they are still creating. They are still enjoying the process. And I want to be like that. And with that being said, I also want to let you all know that, yeah, in case you haven't seen it, we have passed 70k subscribers at 2 million views on YouTube, which is really huge. Okay, so I want to use this medium to thank you all that found my channel worthy of use of your subscribing, of your subscription, and you all that enjoy watching my videos, you all that watch my hairstyle videos, you all that watch my vlogs, you all that watch my sit-down videos. I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. I hope this video encourages someone out there. So with that being said, I think I have come to an end of this video. So if you enjoyed watching, do give this video a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe. And until next time, see you in my video. Bye bye.